Language is everything when building conversational interfaces, and at Rasa, we're making it easier than ever to scale to support multilingual conversational experiences. With our new multi-language content management system in Rasa Studio, you can support as many languages as you want and manage multi-language content across your assistant seamlessly. But don't take my word for it, let's try it out. As you can see, we're currently in the assistant settings part of Rasa Studio, and if I go to configuration, you can see that my default language is currently set to English. This is something that you would set as you go through the assistant onboarding process and build your first assistant. Now, let's imagine that I want to add one or even more languages to my AI assistant. I can go to additional supported languages and select a language from this super long list of possible languages. Now, if you don't find the language that you want to use, you can of course add a custom language, but in my scenario, I'm going to go for German. And add that here and save changes. Now, if that worked, I'll see that my country code pops up under additional languages. And now I know that this assistant is equipped and ready to support German language alongside English. All right, how does this work in practice? I'm going to open up a greeting flow. This is probably something you might have in your own AI assistant. It's for the scenario that someone comes in and just says something like hello and nothing else. Super basic. What's great about this flow, it serves as a good example because it's something that probably won't change across different languages. We know that language can often be linked with locale, and of course different locales might have different processes, but this is a good candidate for a multilingual flow because it can be used across all different languages and likely all different locations as well. Now, in this scenario, you can see that I've currently got just English language here, but I can of course go into my multilingual content management system and I can edit this response in English, or I can also edit this response in German. And I've already added a German response here for the greeting. Now, how would this work if I actually use these two languages when I'm talking with the assistant? Once I have both of those languages set up, ultimately, when I come into the AI assistant and I say, you can see right here, I've currently set my language preference here to English, and I say something like, hello. The user comes into the welcome flow and is delivered the English language greeting back. Now, if I set my language preference here to German and I say, hello, I will get the German greeting back. And this is really great. So you can have one flow and translate it into multiple different languages, all using this content management system for responses. I think this is also great because not only does it help you edit and manage all of these different responses in different languages, but it will also give you a heads up if there's a scenario where you should have a translation where one is missing. You'll get this translation missing button and you can know that, oh, you probably need to translate that response into the language that is missing. So ultimately, in my opinion, having worked on a multilingual assistant myself, I think this can be a really great way to deliver multilingual experiences quickly and manage the content with ease across different content teams working in different languages.